We just got this in from Qatar that the plane that is carrying those five Americans released from Iran that had stopped there, they've now left. They're on their way to Washington, D.C., all five of them and a couple of their family members. This release after two long years of complex diplomatic negotiations for some families, what seemed like it might be an unimaginable outcome. They had a reunion, ending those years of complex diplomatic negotiations. This is the moment the five Americans who were wrongfully imprisoned in Iran finally arrived in Qatar. They're now on a plane, as we said, heading to the U.S. A senior U.S. diplomat tells NBC News those Americans we know exchanged for five Iranians jailed in the U.S. and the release of $6 billion in frozen assets. Several prominent Republicans are denouncing the deal as a ransom payment. Secretary of State Antony Blinken, however, spoke to the human impact, which he says is easy to forget in the abstractions of foreign policy.
Husbands and wives, fathers and children, grandparents can hug each other again, can see each other again, can be with each other again. So it's a day that I'm grateful for.
NBC News Tehran Bureau Chief Ali Arouzi joins me now. We know where the Americans are, but what's the word from Iran and the controversy that still lingers about the release of that $6 billion?
Hey, Chris. Well, the Iranians are obviously very happy about this. They've gotten $6 billion, which they didn't have to spend before at a time of great economic hardship. The economy is in terrible shape here. And they also got back five Iranian prisoners that were being held in U.S. jails for nonviolent crimes, but were helping the government here circumvent U.S. sanctions that had been imposed on them for various things, including Iran's nuclear program. So you can understand why there is some criticism in the United States from Republicans saying that essentially a ransom had been paid for these five Iranian Americans that have been released. And this will only encourage the Iranians to take more hostages because it's such a lucrative trade for them. They also argue that it endangers U.S. troops in the region, U.S. contractors in the region, because they could become a target for the Iranians. And it also gives them a lot of money in their accounts, which they feel that they shouldn't have. Now, the U.S. is arguing that those funds that were held by Korea and are now are in a Qatari bank are going to be under very strict oversight by the Treasury Department. The Iranians deny that. In an exclusive interview with Lester Holt, Iranian's president said, no, that's not the case. We'll spend the money however we want. So there's obviously a gulf between the U.S. and Iran on how that money is going to be spent. But even if there is a lot of oversight from the Treasury Department, it still frees up about $6 billion for the Iranians to spend on whatever they want here, which they didn't have access to. But at the end of the day, as Secretary Blinken said, this was a human issue, and there's got to be enormous joy and relief for those five U.S. citizens heading back home.